death is the illusion as understood by human brain. If you awaken the non-mechanical parts of the human brain, it will have the capacity to see the life with a larger understanding. Children do not have even the level of the brain awareness awakened in the adults. That is why every time when they fall asleep and come out of sleep, they feel they are dead and came back. They strongly believe whatever has happened in dream has really happened. That is why in the dream, if they feel hungry, in the waking state they cry. And whatever has happened in the dream, they feel as truth. The lowest level of brain functioning is responsible for taking your life as bits and pieces without having large vision. Person who thinks every dream is reality, every deep sleep is death, and gets broken, feels the discontinuity during sleep and waking, is unconscious. When the brain grows little more and capable of looking at the life with a larger vision, every night sleep does not feel like death. Every day waking up does not feel like birth. They are able to stitch every sleep and waking up together and call it as life. This is consciousness. If your non-mechanical parts of the brain is also awakened, Kundalini also awakened, you will see lives and deaths by stitching it together as the large life. Ability to see the large life and making your decisions based on those understanding is Jivan Mukti, living enlightenment. Ability to see the large life, different deaths and different births are not discontinuity of your existence. Just like births and deaths are continuity, just like sleep and waking up is the continuity of your life, births and deaths are also continuity of your life. The more you see the continuity of the life, more you become intelligent, more you become blissful, more you become alive, more you are enlightened. Awaken the non-mechanical parts of the brain by Kundalini awakening or any spiritual process as prescribed by incarnations and enlightened beings. You will realize death and birth is just continuity of the different parts of life. Just like sleep and waking and dream is continuity of the same life, birth, death, and the gap between birth and death are all continuity of the same life. Understanding this takes away all the fear, all the possible fear in your life, and gives you tremendous restful awareness. Vast time is in front of you to fulfill your life's purpose and mission. In the time when the greed is dissolved, desire disappears. When there is less time, more greed, then enters desire in your brain and mind. When there is vast time, any amount of greed cannot contaminate the time with a pollution called desire. When the time is available in front of you like ocean, no river of greed can change the color of the ocean, pollute the ocean. If the time is available just only in the size of a lake in front of you, even a small greed stream can pollute the lake. Understand? Time makes an important decision about the levels of your desire and fear. Man who understands the continuity of life and death, in front of whom the vast amount of time is available, who is in the restful awareness with the understanding the vast time is available in front of them, who is not driven by the concept of losing time, is Kalabhairava. When you relax in the restful awareness of the vast time is available in front of you, time becomes your friend. Making time your friend is going beyond time, going beyond death. Then you become Kalabhairava. Just the simple understanding, just like birth, dream, waking, deep sleep, death are all different phases of life. Sleeping, dreaming, waking up, all three are part of same life. If you are conscious, same way, dying, rebirth, the gap between death and rebirth are all part of same life. If you are super conscious, awaken to this truth. Your birth, your death, your gap between birth and death are all part of same life. I, Kalabhairava, tell you all, you don't even need any other spiritual practice. Listen, your life, death, rebirth, gap between life and death, birth and rebirth are all part of your same life. It is not end or restart. This one truth can relax you, put you in restful awareness. You don't need to hurry about your desires, about your greeds. Cosmos is flowing towards you. You are flowing towards the cosmos. You don't need fast track. The moment you understand, you don't need fast track because you have vast time in front of you. All the knots, thought patterns, samskara knots, the grandhis you created in your different energy centers and the thought patterns you created, the thought patterns and samskaras still which you are keeping stiff, straight, gets loosened. The moment thought patterns, samskaras get loosened, they lose their grip over you, you live enlightenment. O human beings, remember this one truth. Kalabhairava, out of my compassion, tremendous love, I am sharing this very sacred secret the basic important truth with you all, O humanity, listen. Your life, your death, the time between life and death, the time between death and rebirth are all part of same life. Do not be afraid. Nothing will be taken away from you, and you do not need urgency, rushing towards any of your goal, greed. You do not need to have fear and escape from any of your fears, anxiety. Neither your greeds nor your fears as urgency of time. Relax from the urgency of time. The restful awareness. Which comes when you relax from the urgency of time. Makes vast time available in front of you. Anybody who has a vast time available in front of them is Kalabhairava. Every one of you can become Kalabhairava when you relax from the immediate urgency of time, when your greeds can't create desire in you, when your fears can't create anxiety in you, you are free from time. The vast time is available in front of you. With the vast time available in front of you, your greed cannot make you urgent. Your fear cannot make you disgraceful. Your fear cannot frighten you. Your greed cannot make you desireful. O human beings, contemplate on this great truth again and again and again. The brain which I am using to radiate this truth to all of you is capable of transmitting that very truths to all your brains. As brains do not have individual consciousness, it is just a biomemory chip in human body. I bless you all to receive the truth, to relate with the truth, to be receptive to this truth. It can be transmitted just like that. It can be easily transmitted. It can just be downloaded. Your birth, your death, your rebirth, the time between the birth and death, time between death and rebirth are all part of same long life. There is no discontinuity in the whole life. Let this one truth sink in all of you to make you understand greed does not create need to create desire in you. In the ocean, when the river enters, it doesn't create ripples. In the vast time available in front of you, by this great truth, even if the greed enters, it does not create the ripples of desire. Even if the fear enters, it does not create the ripples of anxiety. I bless you all. Kala Bhairava puts his footprint on all your brains. Let your biomemories be awakened to this great truth. Birth and death and rebirth and time gap between birth and death, death and rebirth are all part of same long life. There is no discontinuity in these happenings. Kala Bhairava blesses you all with this great truth. Let this great truth be downloaded in all the brains which are having Nayana Diksha. From this brain all over the world. Namah Shivaya. This is the secret of death through which Margandeya conquered Kalabhairava. Margandeya conquered Yama, the Lord of Time. Lord of Time, when he conquers you, he is Yama. When you conquer him, he is Kalabhairava. When you conquer him, you become Kalabhairava. When he conquers you, he is Yama to you. Let this great truth land on all of you. Let this great truth of unbroken long life be established in all the brains. Let every biomemory realize the vast time available in front of us. Let the greed not create desires. Let the fear not create anxiety. Let the restful awareness, sattva, be established in all the biomemories.